think of you. Where your gardens have no walls, breathe in the air of your care. You compare, don't say farewell. Nothing can compare to when you roll the dice and swear.
Pray for God's blessing on them, to share their joy, and to celebrate their love. I'm Matthew David.
I'm Matthew David.
Take you, Lucy Alexandra Hope.
Take you, Lucy Alexandra Hope.
To be my wife. To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health,
in sickness and in health,
to love, cherish and honour,
to love, cherish and honour,
till death us do part,
till death us do part,
according to God's holy law,
according to God's holy law,
in the presence of God I make this vow,
in the presence of God I make this vow.
I, Lucy Alexandra Hope,
I, Lucy Alexandra Hope,
take you, Matthew David,
to be my husband,
to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love, cherish and to obey, till death us do part, according to God's holy law, in the presence of God I make this vow. Lucy, I give you this ring.
Lucy, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
within the love of God,
within the love of God,
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Matthew, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage. With my body, I honor you. All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you. Within the love of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. In the presence of God and before this congregation, Matt and Lucy have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, for you have created joy and gladness, pleasure and delight, love, peace and fellowship. Pour out the abundance of your blessing upon Matt and Lucy in their new life together. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that banquet where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
So they say, looking back at our 3.5 years together, we can see how God has brought us together, taken us through some tough and some joyful times, moulding us into the couple that he wants us to be. And they say, this marriage is a testament to God's perfect and amazing plan. I also ask people to write things that they love about the other person. Are you interested in that? I ask them to five things that they love about each other. I know they could go on further than that, but here's. Are you really interested in this?
Yeah.
Matt's list. Here are several things that I love about Lucy. Number one, I love that she's a woman of God, learning and growing in her own personal faith and walk with God. Two, I love how she's so supportive of me in what I do and have done in the past. Three, I love that she loves me for who I am, despite all my flaws and failures. Four, I love the way that she's so thoughtful and caring of others, a real inspiration to me. I love the way she looks, finally, there's an obvious physical attraction. Oh yeah. Should we give Matt a round of applause for his list? And then Lucy writes, "Hello Anthony, I'm sorry this is late getting to you." Here are three things I love about Matt. Number one, that he's a man of prayer, and whenever anything goes wrong, I know that's the first thing that he does. Number two, he makes up very unfunny jokes in the attempt to make you laugh. This includes changing words to songs to make them relevant to me. Number three, he will do small things like my washing without me knowing, just to tick something off my long list that I always have. He does it without moaning or telling me, and even when I ask, he doesn't boast about it. It'll never last.
I'm
strip. I gotta find a new place where the kids are hip. My buddies and me, you're getting real well known. Yeah, the bad guys know us and they leave us alone.
Nothing could make me happier than to walk my beautiful grown-up daughter down the aisle and see her married to the man that she loves. Matt, as I said this afternoon, is a fine, strong and caring Christian young man, and we're delighted to have him as our son-in-law. And we know that together you'll be very happy in your new home and church in Manchester. From the moment she was born, Lucy has been very, very special to me. My favourite youngest daughter. And it seemed just yesterday that she'd happily sit on my shoulders as we walked to the park, or pedal her go-kart up and down the drive, or take her pet rabbit past it for a walk up the road. So in that moment during the service this morning, as I gave Lucy's hand away, there was a realisation that my little Lucy legs had grown up, and however much I'd like things to go back, some of my roles as Lucy's father are now complete. And are the responsibility of Matt, her husband, the man now responsible for her protection, her provision, and her care. So, ladies and gentlemen, Will you join me in raising your glasses to my daughter and her husband?
Expecting the worst. Are you gonna drop the bomb or not?